Well, guys, you can actually see in the photos here, the snow is shifted right there at the summit of the mountain. He was able to take these photos once he made it back down the hill safely. And it was just hours later that he learned about that skier who died in an avalanche on the same day.
I was like, oh, wow, like, you know, that could have been me, you know.
Ismail Kaye back on the mountain Monday, this time snowboarding.
Didn't fall as much as I thought I would.
After nearly missing being caught up in an avalanche in the backcountry while out snowshoeing with his dog yesterday.
I took a few more steps and then I noticed that the whole mountain like was sliding down towards me. And it was like, I'd never seen that before. I mean, I've only seen it in movies.
Heart racing. He says all he could do was think to run away.
But of course, I turned around, tripped over. And then, you know, I just got buried in the snow and you know, I struggled to like just get my head out of the snow and turn around and look back. And like the whole thing had like stopped like just a few feet from me.
The snow finally settling. Kaye, following his original tracks, made it to a safer spot downhill.
The snow was just kind of falling towards me, sliding towards me. And it was very scary because I didn't know if it was going to continue.
Nearly to the summit when the avalanche started, Kaye says he's done this path on Red Mountain several times with his dog Trumpet. But Sunday, something seemed off with his husky Malamute mix.
Going up and my dog was actually behind. I didn't understand why, you know, because all the way to a point before when I started going straight up, like he had been in front. He was a little bit afraid and he was falling behind. And I didn't understand why, because he loves the snow. Either he knew that there was an avalanche risk.
Thankful, he made it home to his family. He said he's going to take some avalanche training classes now and be prepared for next time he heads out in the snow.
It's one of those, you know, close calls. Someone said on the post that, you know, maybe sometimes close calls are wake up calls.
Now, before you hit the backcountry, rescue crews suggest that you tell someone where you are going. Don't go alone. Always carry a beacon, a shovel, and a propole. Courtney Fromm, Fox 31.